All right, guys, welcome back. We're going into the second hour here of Bounce Power. Pocket will be right back. Adam, what's going on?
Well, I'm really excited that, you know, you and I had this conversation in which I said it was okay for you to play the Death Star. So yeah. I'm looking forward to seeing
what you're doing. Thought he was just a little angry BB-8 that rolled a guy over.
Honestly, that's what I thought. I thought he was evil BB-8, and I was so excited about that.
Tiny sphere.
You know, Adam, I scrap everything. I'm just the evil BB-8.
Yeah, you're BB-hate.
BB-hate. It's BB-hate. There you go. There you go.
BB-H-8.
Yeah, coincidentally, also my favorite jazz musician.
Yep.
So I think we start back with the Thunderdome, where is your captive, and are you with her? Like, set the scene for me for that.
So she is now in a metal bikini at the foot of my my throne.
God damn it, we're full crazy over here. We're full crazy.
Yeah. So what you missed is that all the, like, after that scene happened, all like I clapped my hands, I did one of these, and all the like dancer girls that were around grabbed her and sort of like rushed her off into like the, I don't know, I guess there's a changing room back there. Really, it's just an old shed we have out back. And they like forced her into, like, she's like, they like scrubbed her down and washed her. And then, like, yeah, when you see her next, she's in a metal bikini and laying at the foot of my thing. She's all chained up. And I'm sitting there making awful hut jokes.
Yes.
About how she said I was a hut, so I might as well act like one.
Oh, so, man, yeah. she's so angry.
Yeah. Oh,
she's not buying it. Yeah.
And around her, my little furry man is just dancing. Dancing. And I'm sitting there swirling my drink as like a band named Misto and the Misfits plays, and they're just like,
yeah.
Yeah. And I'm just waiting, and I'm sitting
the dirtiest biz in Selves 12 systems gets played right here.
Yes.
The place is like, they're all super excited, right? That like the original swoop gangers, those thugs that were outside the cantina, they're all very pleased with themselves now, because I assume you've made them your like chief lieutenants and like,
oh yeah, yeah. They're all my top guys, and they all have their own underlings now, and our gang has grown significantly, and we are just like, it's very obvious that we, like, at least to us, run the show. It may not be true, but we fully believe that we are like in charge of the mid-city.
This game became George Lucas Presents The Wire so gradually. I didn't even notice it happening. So,
oh yeah, we also run in drugs and all sorts of other drugs.
Right, but it's part of the cover.
Absolutely.
All right, so I think that's the scene that Belsa and Lana walk in on. That's what you see, is all of that stuff happening. And I assume, did you tell the guards to let your friends in when they show up, or do they have to like deal with like security?
You know what? I don't say.
Nice.
I don't say.
Great. Anything. Now you have two pissed off women coming in, and they got to deal with guards.
So yeah, so the two of you see all this stuff happening, but as soon as you come inside, two guards with big like vibro axes like put them together to block your path.
Are the stormtroopers still with us?
I mean, that's up to you. They're going to draw a lot of attention because they are like, you could pass.
They left us when we entered into the Undercity. Like they left, like, yeah, came by the gate and waited.
You could pass as non-Imperials, but they are the Empire.
Okay, yeah. Let's just end it just us.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah, so these two guards, you know, these swoop gangers, they block your way. And one of them shakes his head and he's like, sorry, ladies, I don't know you. And if I don't know you, you don't get in.
That's my guard.
What's the guard's name, Jesse?
Thaviticus Pooch is his name.
He prefers Mr. Pooch.
Mr. Pooch.
he's a little embarrassed about his first name, but he comes from a long line of pooches.
Can we see back at all? Like, can we see back to see what, like,
any... I think you can, like, lean to try to, like, look, and you just see, like, the crowd and, like, You can hear Cheezle like giggling and laughing, and like you can hear the music, and it's loud and busy. But you can't see Theron from where you are.
And I just, you know, I don't bother looking around. I'm still very monotone, still very angry looking. And I just say, we were summoned.
The other guard is like, oh, you hear that, Mr. Pooch? They were summoned. And Mr. Pooch looks at you.
The other guard's name is Remos Rimo. He's a little, Remos Rimo's and Leviticus Pooch are the two guards out front. They're good men. They're good family men.
So Mr. Pooch says to Remos, he's like, oh, they were summoned. Well, that changes everything, doesn't it, Remos? And Remos is like, yeah, Mr. Pooch, we always have people who are summoned in. And then they both look at you and scowl like, get out of here.
While they're looking at Lana, Elsa goes to speak, but she like catches a whiff of them. She's like, oh, goodness. And she sideways, she just pulls a blaster pistol from her hip and just like aims it at one of the guys' face.
Yeah.
And it's okay. Like, go get your boss.
And they take a step back. Why don't you make a coerce roll? Let's see if you can coerce these guards. Let's see what they're. How good are Theron's guards? Let's
see. They're my top men.
Hired thug.
What's the difficulty, boss?
Hired thugs have a willpower of two, so two purple.
Goons, hired goons.
Hired goons.
Hired goons.
Coercion, right?
Yes, yeah, because you're threatening.
Okay, boom.
Ooh. You point the gun in the guy's face, and I think I know how to give you your advantage here. So he takes a step back because he's startled by the gun, but he's not afraid. And he starts to like chuckle, and he's like, feisty one. The butcher likes them feisty. And Remos is like, that's right. That's right. The butcher could always use another slave. And he kind of like sells you. And then he takes a step back and looks over his shoulder. And that gives you a corridor of sight to be able to see a robed figure in a throne on a dais that looks vaguely familiar. And then also you see Lana. I think you see her. You see Tala, and she's like chained up and wearing a metal bikini.
While they're distracted, can I try and sneak past, or like push past them, and like just go straight for where? Tala is like, I just like really angry, and I just like start charging through the crowd.
Yeah, definitely do it. Make a I guess probably like an athletics check just to shove the one guy out of the way. And you can take an advantage die from Belsa's other or take a boost die from Belsa's other advantage.
And two difficulty.
These guys are no three difficulty because they're stronger than they are willed. Okay. Ooh, whoa! Okay, you get to make the best, coolest possible entrance that you want. I'm turning it over to you. What does it look like? You blow past these guys like they're made out of tissue paper.
It's just like a choo-choo train. You just see her charging in. She's fully angry. And her
Just like disarm them at the same time and just fucking whoop their ass as you go?
Yeah, like, so this is the thing. Like, I'm totally just turning it over to you. You can be as ostentatious or as subtle as you want. Theron can notice you or not. It's totally up to you. So
I think as they go and they're messing with Belsa, I grab one of the guy's axes and I hit, like, I use the end of it, not the actual vibro part of it, but the end to like sort of knock him out. And then I look over to the other guy and I drop the axe and then just start charging in to land in front of Tala. And before I can even say anything to Theron, I'm already like, my fist is just going straight for her face.
So, okay.
That's about it. Like, I've pretty much just forgotten anyone else exists.
Can we rewind this scene and have her go through, you know, that song from Kill Bill, that one that's like the horns and shit? Slow-mo walking through, his guys are like, whoa.
Yeah, like, there's definitely.
She's just knocking everyone out.
Yes, he's like, one, two, and like, it's going like, through.
Well, I mean, I'm going to be knocking some dudes out. I mean, they're probably going to try and stop me.
The thing is, there would be, like, the guard thing got breached, right? So there would be people, like, reaching for you or being like, hey, you can't be here. And yeah, in slow motion, like, you're just, like, punching them in the face. Like,
it's literally the Daredevil Cardinal scene.
Yeah, but, like, less fighting back and forth and more just, like, judoing people as they could get in your way.
Slow-mo badassness with a killer soundtrack, and you're just like destroying dudes.
Yeah. And so at the very last note, the big last like stab of the entrance music coincides perfectly with, because you want to come in and punch her in the face, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, it coincides perfectly with you hitting her in the face, and she like falls backwards, and that's when it snaps back into normal speed. Apparently, it's George Lucas Presents The Wire as directed by Zack Snyder. We're getting cinematically also, very confused today.
Also, this is the bar, just to clarify, is less like it's Mad Maxy, but it's more like Batman and Robin Mad Maxy. That's kind of like dudes have spray paint skulls on. Like,
you're talking about Batman and Robin from like the Mr. Freeze episode. Or
it's neon.
Whoever directed that shit show.
Everywhere.
Is that Schumacher? Yeah. I forgot who it was. Anyways,
Absolutely.
Yeah. Totally tasteless.
Yep.
Yeah.
The most tasteless gang that ever existed. Yeah.
Yep. Everyone's flashy.
Perfect. And you slam your fist into her face. Cheezel goes like running to hide behind the throne. like he's a person, like he's just a human being. But we're all like, I mean, can we go back and just make him an Ewok? Because he's acting like one.
That would be great.
He's just a short man and furs in lots
of. You've dressed him up like an Ewok then.
Yeah.
All right. So he runs and flees, and with a heavy rattling of her chains, Tala falls back and like brings her hand up to her face and like looks at you.
Is she on the ground right now?
I'm
gonna put my foot on her throat and just put some pressure there, and then look up at Theron and go, "What the fuck happened to you?"
So we see that.
Recognize what's going on.
Yeah, we knock her down, and then like kind of fall on her and put your boot on her throat so she can't get up, and then the shot pans all the way up the stairs again to Theron, and then that's when you're like, what happened to you?
Theron just like has the biggest grin on his face as like it like wide shot, like all the goons are like slowly getting up and like like trying to find their blasters on the ground, and I'm like, that's my girl. And I take like a huge drink. I'm like, well, look who decided to show up, and give like a little nod to Lana, who's way in the back still.
To Belsa, yeah.
Oh yeah, Belsa, sorry.
Belsa's like carefully making her way over like unconscious goons.
We're like holding
my robes and dress. I'm just like stepping over these unconscious goons, like working my way towards them.
Awesome.
I look back to, and I'm like, Belsa, get over here. And then I say it again. I'm like, what happened? We haven't heard from you. And I see you got a present.
And
I like, I increase pressure on her throat as I say that.
Yeah, she snarls at you.
And Theron looks down at the prisoners like, Lana, if you kill her, she can't tell us what she knows. And you want to know what she knows, don't you?
I'm sure Belsa can sense this, but there's like just this like anger still. And it just only intensifies because she knows Theron's right, and she just doesn't want Theron to be right. And so she's like, yes, but how are we going to make her talk?
And Theron looks back to Belsa, and he's like, now that's the fun part. And takes like a crazy drink, and then like, throws his glass into the air, and like all of a sudden the music starts back up, and like all the lights and like the gangsters are like, yeah! Everyone starts dancing around again.
Belsa has like a wry grin, and she's just like, glad to see you've recovered, sir.
Yeah. And so and then I sort of like pull on the chain so that our prisoner, like her head snaps back to like hit the little side of the thing of like the stairs. And so it's just tight. Like, I'm not trying to hurt her or anything. I'm just like, like it's time to have some fun.
Okay. So I guess we could probably roll and then just cut to like the after effects of the like what you learned from her. I guess what method do you use? Like how are you gonna try and get her to talk?
Sammy, how are we gonna torture her? What are we gonna do?
Putter.
Look, I am. If anything, I'm a benevolent ruler. You can do whatever you like. I'm here to facilitate her torture. I will gladly, if I can roll better, I'll gladly torture her too. Whatever, it doesn't matter to me as long as we get results. I want to know where Greenskin is. That's what I want to know.
Who's the more like charming one or something?
Yeah, what are our stats? Who's the most charming out of all of us? It's not charming, it'd be coercion, right? Well,
coercion, coercion is torture, but if you want a good cop, bad cop her, it'd be a combination of someone can charm and someone can coerce.
Coercion is definitely you. You have
insane. My coercion and charm are probably the highest out of everyone.
I'm hands down.
Yellows for each.
Yeah. Okay.
So we're like in a back room. And you can sort of hear the thumping and the party outside, but it's clearly a room that no one enters, but me. And it is just like a chair and a really shitty light, and that sort of like sways to the beat of the music outside. And then it's the three of us just standing around, and she is.
We can be like the people that like you're sitting there talking, but then like if she doesn't comply, then we're the ones that hit her or something.
Sure.
So,
or I guess
so
Belsa wouldn't do that. She might break a nail.
I think what we see is like, y'all are in the room, and we maybe follow like whoever the last person is to go in. Maybe follow Lana, and Lana, you pass between two more of these like two of the guards, two of the Swoop Gang guards, and they've got like those kind of like face masks, like helmets on. We can see their eyes, and they're holding vibro axes as you go past, and when you pass them, none of you see this, but you see the two of them like they turn and like look at each other, and one of them just like nods slowly, and then the door closes behind you, and then now you're inside, you're in this room, you're in Theron's special room,
and I tell Lana to bind her to the chair.
I do. I have binding things, so
and
I'm really rough, and I make sure that it's like brushing against her skin really harshly, so that way it starts to like sink into the skin.
God, like father, like door. Jesus.
Yo, I'm angry. She threatened me with my child. Like Lana's pretty much like losing her mind right now with anger.
Yeah, I know.
And Belsa can sense that.
So Theron sort of walks behind her and looks down at her and is like, so let's start with an easy question. Oh, and he slowly starts shedding his robes as he's like walking around her and like leaving them on the ground.
Just pools of robe.
Yeah, pools of robes. And it's just like underneath is this like really messed up tattered Imperial uniform. And he's like, let's start with an easy one. Did you ever have Lana's child?
She scowls at you, she's like, why are you asking me questions you know the answer to?
I'd like to establish a baseline before I ruin a person. And he like sort of taps her on the back of the head.
Yeah. I think she laughs and she's like, I'm not afraid of you.
Theron sort of smiles. He's like, oh, it isn't me you should be afraid of. I'm just here to ask questions. If you answer my questions, I have no problem allowing you to live out the rest of your days here at my fine abode. Surely that's better than any alternative.
She looks up at you and she's like, I'd rather be eaten by a rancor.
I'm working on getting one of those. And Theron like laughs. And turns around. He's like, all right, so where is Greenskin?
She shakes her head. She's like, nowhere you'll ever find him.
And then he sort of approaches her again and gives her like a little nice little slap on the face. And he's like, where's Greenskin?
I mean, I think she's contractually obligated to spit at you if you're.
Oh, oh yeah, of course. Yeah,
that's her. That's what she does now.
And Theron, like, I assume it hits him like a little bit on the cheek.
Mm-hmm.
And he wipes it off and then like smears it on her face.
Yeah.
And he's like, I love it when they fight. Where's Greenskin? And he sort of like punches her on the shoulder a little bit, like progressively mm-hmm. just getting more and more violent, but not like each time just a little bit more.
Okay. Well, let's roll coercion and let's see if that works. The corporal has a willpower of 4.
Okay.
And a discipline of 2. So you're looking at 2 purple and 2 red is the difficulty for this okay. this roll.
I, because I'm like that. Do I get any bonus things at all?
If somebody else is helping you, you could get a boost die. You can spend one of your destiny points to get an upgrade.
Well, I have something called intimidating. I'm ranked 2 intimidating, which is downgrades the difficulty of coercion checks.
Oh, perfect. Okay, so put a downgrade on the difficulty side.
Gravy.
Yeah. Right. So that'll turn one of her red dice into a purple, which is cool.
Oh, okay. Downgrade. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think this should. I'll do a coercion, and let's see what happens.
All right. So it takes place over, like, it's not a single session kind of thing. So you lean in and you, like, we can see the violence starting to escalate, and we get the Imperial brutality, fade, the PG fade. So it like wipes. I think we see her after, and it's been like some amount of time of, torture later.
Never mind. Chat's saying that it should yeah. be 2 ranks.
It should be 2 because you're 2.
Oh, you have intimidate 2?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, roll it again.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, that's fine.
I didn't know, chat.
This is exactly torturing people with strong willpower is exactly what intimidating is for.
Great.
There you go. All right.
Much better.
All right.
So instead, yeah, we see her We see her chained up still, and she, we don't need to go over the details of how she was tortured, but she's like pale and sweaty. And what's more important than any of the physical stuff about her is that we can see it on her face that she has given up. She knows that she cracked and that her like will was broken, and that she's given up where Greenskin is.
I don't want to spoil how she was cracked, but involved the little dude dancing for about 25 minutes.
And he just danced. Now we will subject you.
Stop!
To cheese it.
He puts thumbtacks on his feet. Yeah.
Stop shimmying.
Stop. Make the mad dance stop.
He's so tiny and so furry. Why won't he stop? Yeah, she lost it.
How is he not an Ewok? Yeah. So she's just like totally, totally broken. And what are the, like, I guess we pan across from her and we see the three of you. What do y'all look like? How has your demeanor changed after?
How is the like lighting? Is it like one of those like scenes where they're interrogating when the light seems to just shine on the table or the chair where she's at and the rest of it's kind of like darker?
Yeah, I'm envisioning I'm envisioning a room that we can't tell how big or small it is because there is that sort of like column of light effect. And you all come out the shadowy edge of it.
Yeah, I'm just leaning against a wall, like just completely stone-faced, just waiting for Theron to give me any sort of permission to mess her up. But you just no reaction whatsoever as she's talking.
Mm-hmm.
Theron just sort of looks back at her and then back to Lana and is like, we can't kill her yet. We don't know if she's telling the truth. But when the time comes, trust me, she's all yours.
And you just see like a smirk on Lana's face and that's it. I mean, I don't know if you see it, but the camera does.
And I imagine we have coordinates or some type of location where Greenskin's at.
Yeah. So he's hiding out in the lower city, and he moves around. And so you know where he's going to be for about a week. And he tries to move around so he can't get pinned down. So she tells you his current location. And you know, just from like the interaction, and we know as an audience from looking at her face, that she's not trying to pull anything and didn't like, there's no lie. Like, it worked. She broke.
Theron, I guess instead of getting stormtroopers for this one, I'd like to bring in my entire gang for one great last raid. And we're going to go crazy on this one. So like I go before the gangsters.
Okay. So you leave the special room. Yeah. And head out. And
I'd say I'm the last to leave the room, and as I walk by, because I'm assuming she's still tied down, I like smack her lightly on the cheek and blow her a kiss and just mm-hmm. walk out.
Yeah, and she just doesn't respond. She doesn't say or do anything. She just kind of like takes it, like just kind of hanging there limp.
Yeah. And we totally just leave her in the room.
So. Yeah. Cool.
Cheese it or whatever.
Yeah, and he's like, yeah, I don't know. Cheezel's just still dancing. He has not stopped dancing this
time. No, he's not capable of it.
I feel like he's just a stim addict that you found or something, and you found him dancing, and you're just like, yes, no, this will do. And then you brought him to your bar.
Absolutely. No, that's his backstory.
Yeah. Yep. Nice.
Great.
Okay.
Fantastic.
He gets paid in death sticks.
So you head upstairs and go back out into the main room, and your Muppets are having a party, as they do. And so you wanted to start like getting everybody together to like talk about what the plan is.
Yeah, and so I give a like a rousing like brothers, and it's like and the lights are shining, and like dudes are spray painting their faces and stuff, and I'm just like, we have been called for glorious purpose. The location of Greenskin has been discovered. Everyone's like, yeah. That's like literally our entire goal is to find Greenskin. So everyone's like, they're going crazy. And and I'm like, together we shall capture this foul creature. They're like, like literally every sentence is a freak out.
Of course.
Yeah.
Punctuation.
And, yes, and like all the guys are like getting their gear and they're getting ready to go, and they're like pushing all the like various men and women sexy slaves off of them, and they're just like yeah, let's go do this. And I'm like, I guess I know the location is where, like, it's just the Undercity?
Yeah. I don't think the, like, specific, like, on the corner of this street, and that street matters. Like, you could go there at any time.
All right. And I'm like, to the Undercity! And everyone's like, aah!
So while this speech is happening, you know, we get we see the view from outside, and there's you know, we can hear the music playing with all the like the low pass filter on it, and we see three of your swoop ganger like guards just like lying unconscious in the street, and we see a group of like commandos like somebody gives like hand signs and like move up to the door. They'll have like blaster rifles and helmets and, like combat packs. And the two of them that are one on either side of the door, they like the guy counts like he's like two, and the other guy takes out he's got like a silver ball and he like twists it. The other guy opens the door and the dude throws the ball inside, and I think that like everybody's shouting and everything, and nobody notices this guy. Like, he's obviously like the only dude that noticed the thing. Something like hits him, this baseball size thing hits him in the head, and he like. Yeah, and he like looks down and he picks it up and he's like, what the heck is, and it's like this little ball and it's got little red lights blinking. They go like 3, 2, and then his eyes go wide, and then there's like a bright flash. And there's an explosion in the bar, And the suddenly, like, it's chaos, right? Like, a bunch of people get knocked down. There's smoke. You can hear blaster fire, and you can see the, like, red bolts of, like, blasters being fired as they, like, breach the door and start coming in. Your place is being attacked.
Can I'd say I react immediately and try to grab Theron and signal for Belsa to follow and go back to grab the woman and get her, like, try to, is there a back end or, like, a way to get out the back at all, or... Is that the only way to get in?
Like, I figured. Well, it's a no. It's a cantina, so there'd be several exits, right?
So yeah, I'd say that we like grab the girl and go like out a different entrance.
Okay, so you spring into action and you grab you grab there and you're like, we gotta go and like surveying answers. Okay.
Yeah.
And what do you, Theron? What do? Do you issue like a command to your men before you run off?
Yeah. Or? Yeah. No, I signal to Lana to go grab the our hostage, but I don't like I would stay and try to lead a fight because they're only at the doorway, right? They're not like
they breached the door and knocked out like a bunch of guards. People are there's chaos. You know, we pan across the scene and like some people are firing back. There's a lot of smoke. There's a like a Twi'lek like a. Just like strangling some guy, like he's like lying on his back and she's like throttling him, like all chaos is broken out. The jizz band is like quickly trying to put their instruments in their cases and they're like, oh, we're not a part of this, we're trying to get away.
I'd be like pointing at the like upper echelon of guys to be like, get these dudes under control and stop whatever's happening.
All right, so let's get a. I'll get a test from you. Do a leadership test.
Okay.
And you're on your home turf, but your men are not particularly disciplined. So, let's say two purples in the difficulty, but I'm gonna spend a point to upgrade.
That's an upgrade for you.
Yeah, upgrade on that.
Can I give him advantage?
A boost die? You want to help? Yeah. Yeah. How are you helping?
I think I'm just like helping him coordinate his commands to the men.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Sure. Yeah. Because you've got a good. I mean, you can see the places for people to get cover, and like they're fighting like a bunch of irregulars, but you can be like, just stand behind that. You go here, and then it's got the power of Theron's.
Yeah, so I'd say I just go full tactician mode in the smoke, and I'm just like trying to get people into cover and stuff.
Okay.
Cool.
All right, here we go. Leadership, go.
Nice. Okay. Yeah. So they'll hold the line while you flee. You know, like if these are like actual like Republic commandos. That your gang will eventually be overwhelmed. Like you have numbers now, but they're untrained in this kind of combat. So you can make a choice, right? They'll hold it as long as you want them to. But if you want some of them to stay alive, you know, you want to give them a time to bail out.
Like the main biker, like the original biker gang. That was there. However many guys those were, I signaled to them to like set our troops to like fight back. But like you dudes and I, we're getting out of here.
Instead
of
you, okay.
Yeah, I went back to grab.
So while you're doing that, Lana, you run down to grab her. And when you get downstairs, you notice those two guards that were like blocking the door. They're gone. And the door inside. Into the like torture chamber.
I've already got my blade out as I've been running just in case someone pops through somewhere else. And I run inside the room that we were just in.
Okay. So you run in, you open the door, and the like the empty chains that were holding her are just like lying there in the pool of light.
Is there any indication of where she might have gone based on like blood dripping or something?
Maybe, yeah. Do you have a tracking ability of some kind? Probably survival.
Perception? Oh, would it be survival? I mean, I could roll it. I don't really have.
Let me see. Yeah, survival is tracking. Yeah.
Okay. So just roll. What's the difficulty?
She's injured, so I'll call it difficulty 2, but you get a boost die because you're looking for blood. That was a good.
It's blue? Good.
Yeah, it's one blue.
Okay. Let's see. Survival.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. There's like bloody like footprints. She's definitely injured and exhausted. So the two guards are like helping her get out the back exit.
So I immediately comms to Theron, and I'm like, she's escaped. Someone's got her. She's escaping out the back.
And I, you know, you can hear gunfire and like the few biker guys that are with me all screaming and like shooting behind them. And I'm like, well, then now's your chance to kill her. And I like shut off the comms and like, we like all are trying to catch up to you, but you know, we're in a gunfight. Pew, pew, pew.
Yeah. So I just run after her then.
Okay. So, yeah, you head out, you chase off after her. And we come back to the bar, and like there are strains of the sort of triumphant like Rebel Alliance theme like playing as these Republic commandos are you know working their way through the bar, putting down the guards. And I think that we hear a faint like sound, like a rumbling sound or something in the distance. There's this kind of like rattling noise, and they're pressing forward. They're not Imperial troops, so they're not just like blasting everybody. So they're like,
God damn it. Putting, amazing intro. Oh,
this is gonna be so good.
They're putting manacles on people, and they're like moving through the bar, firing. Your men are falling back. You've had to fall back somewhere. So where are Belsa and Theron?
We're like, me and the biker dudes are like taking position behind the throne, mm-hmm. and sort of like shooting out from behind the throne.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so they're moving up towards the throne, taking the advantage. You can see now, like through the smoke, that they're like professionally equipped, Republic commandos, and so they all like get behind some cover, and one of them shouts to you. They're like, Agent Theron Talon. Come out with your hands up. You're under arrest by order of the New Republic.
And Theron like just pops a shot off at the guy.
All right. Yeah. The commando, he shakes his head, and he's like, all right, boys, set to stun. And they all like flip their thing because they're going to try to capture you. And they get up, and that like rolling noise, kind of like we hear that again from before. And the camera pans to the like the door and like some of the like debris, and we can see the Republic commandos. Do you want to tell us how you make your entrance?
Please do. Please do. I'm
so
very excited.
Are they at the front door? You're saying, or are they on? You said they were shooting
inside,
down.
They're inside. Yeah.
Okay. Are their backs to the front door?
Yes. Yeah. Definitely.
Okay. I guess it should be stated that we're saying ball, but this is like a four foot diameter ball, right?
It's a big ass sphere. Yeah.
It's a big ass metal sphere. Yeah. Yeah.
It literally is just a giant ball.
Yeah.
Currently.
Okay.
JP's character is Michael Crichton's sphere.
Exactly. And so I guess I like, okay, I guess I did that before. So I literally just like roll down the front door and try to like roll onto one of these guys.
Mm-hmm.
And when I roll onto one of them, I like stop, and you see the ball lean forward, and you see two legs come out from the front, and then one in the back in like a arc type thing. And then mm-hmm. this droid comes out. The 6 foot droid is just formed in the center. And how far away am I from Theron at the moment?
I mean, you're across the room, from him. So, you know, he can see all this happening.
Okay. All right. So that happens. And then like, as I'm in the full droid form, I look over, or like, you see me kind of adjust, and I adjust over towards Theron, and let's see if I can actually, this is the first time I've ever worked this. Let's just see how this goes.
Theron.
And I'm just sitting there staring at Agent Theron with like, I don't have any, you just see my two arms, but I've rolled over one guy, and the two others are like standing
next
to me.
There's a Republic commando lying underneath the droid, just like kind of crushed, like trying to reach up, and he like puts his bloody handprint on your leg. And yeah, they're in this like battle droid just like blasts into the room. And do you have guns for hands, or is there like something
right now? Gun? I just have two normal hands.
Yeah, okay. And you have the like the Imperial gear is like clearly marked.
Well, I guess to fully go into the what it looks like the outside was all black with a red Imperial gear on it, but when I go into droid mode, the inside is all red while the back is still black.
Mm-hmm.
And so like that's what you see in front of you. It's just this triped triped yep. droid with two arms. It's about 6 feet tall. Who's just rolled over this one commando in front of you. And he looks at Theron and says that.
Theron from behind the chair, the throne, it, like, gives a little like affirmative wave and then turns back behind and like looks at the other goons and then like slinks down and puts his fingers in his ears. He's like, oh. And all the other guys around him are like, oh, they start doing it too.
Yeah.
Okay, you just hear affirmative. And then basically you see like the right arm, like the left arm kind of goes inside. And the right arm turns into this giant vibro axe and then just goes down and like tries to jump the commando to the left of him.
Yeah. So the commandos, we see the droid change shape, right? We see the axe like flip out, and your combat motors start to whir. And we cut back to the goons and Theron like hiding behind the thing, and all we hear is just like screaming and like blaster fire. And maybe like some blood like splashes on the throne.
And a Wilhelm scream.
Yeah, totally Wilhelm. And then when we pan back, there's just commandos like lying all over the floor, and the droid is like covered in blood.
Great. And yep. I do I get to roll for the commando, or does he just get chopped down?
Do you want to, I guess like this is the thing, is that I'm willing to like let you like just get rid of these dudes. Because they're not really, the threat is they were just buying time for the prisoner to escape. That's the real thing. But I want to see how the two react, because you didn't, Theron, you didn't expect any giant robot backup.
No, Theron looks around and like looks at his guys and he's like, go see how many of ours are still alive. And he comes around the throne and at this point is like in his crappy Imperial outfit and sort of like walks down the stairs and like gives the droid like this like inquisitive look like, And he's like, and you are?
ZN-Z1L reporting for duty, sir.
And Theron's like, I don't seem to recall requesting backup.
What's the name of Theron's boss again, Adam? You're muted.
Sorry, Fox? Commander Fox, I believe was his name. Yeah.
Commander Fox sent me, sir.
Theron gives like a half-ashamed cackle, and he's like, oh, God. I'll never hear the end of this. He's like, all right, Z, let's do this.
Affirmative.
Then is there still one guy left?
Yeah, sure.
So I guess maybe like the two arms, like the vibro sword like goes back in, or the vibro axe like goes back inside. I just grab the other guy with two arms and just rip him apart. right down the center. Yeah.
And the last thing we see where you're like telling you like, yeah, all right, let's do this, and then we see the guy get picked up by his arms, he's like, no, and then it cuts away, and we see there's like an alley outside, and Lana, you like burst out the side door, and you're like tracking your prey.
Yeah.
So what do you want to do? Do you want to just like chase after them and then?
Oh, I'm gonna immediately try to kill the people rescuing or the two guards.
Okay. Okay. So yeah. So you.
Them, I'm gonna immediately try to slash at them.
Yeah, you got a success, so you can see them. You can follow them as far as you want.
Okay.
So they're still pretty far away for slashing distance. You know, you'll get to a point where you're gonna need like a clear space between the two of them to sprint and then jump in and attack.
Okay.
So I think that you follow them. They've given her like a cloak and are trying to they're trying to hide basically in the crowd. And I think you start to head out and follow them through the crowd.
Do I see that, Adam?
No, but okay. Lana has a calm on her. So.
Can Belsa chase Lana?
Yeah.
I kind of wasn't involved in this situation, but
definitely, you can be.
So let's say like I'm the same distance from Lana as she is from them.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, instead of attacking immediately, I'm gonna try and get as close as I can. Then, like as they're trying to go through the crowd, I'm gonna try and get as close as I can to them.
So I guess while I can,
go ahead.
Well, I guess while I'm like in the room with Theron, I just kind of like I'm standing there, like blood's kind of dripping out, and then I just look at and ask,
"What is your order, sir?"
What is the likelihood of it catching up with the other two? Like, how far out are they comparatively to where we're at now?
I mean, his top speed is pretty decent, but they're made for more like open terrain, right? Like, he's gonna end up running into people and like have to get through that. So that'll be the thing that causes problems.
All right.
Yeah. And they're explicitly trying to blend into the crowd. So,
yeah. All right. So I basically tell our new robot friend, our new droid, that just to watch the front door while the men get we figure out how many actual goons we still have left, and then we're gonna head down to the lower city.
Affirmative.
Cool. So, Lana, you are, so you're saying you want to sneak up on them?
Yeah. I'd like to sneak up behind them if I can.
Okay. Yeah. Make a stealth test. And it's going to be, let me see these rebel troops. Let's see what their perception is. Okay. Alliance infantry. They have a vigilance. Okay, so it's going to be one yellow and one green.
Adam, am I close enough to the situation to manipulate the stealth advantage?
I don't know. It depends. How would you make it easier for Lana to remain unnoticed?
Well, I can upgrade the difficulty check to identify per indistinguishable, so I can give her up to two.
Oh, that's, I mean, indistinguishable is for you. That's a thing that's true about you, not somebody else.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Am I close enough to exert my power of the force to hide myself and hide her?
You're indistinguishable. It's a mundane ability though, right? Like it's not a force power.
Right, but I have sleight of mind too, which is one blue dice to all stealth checks.
Oh yeah, definitely sleight of mind for sure. You can definitely roll that.
Cool. Yeah. Yeah.
You said one green, one yellow, but
that's what they have. So it's a red and a purple for you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's
And then I get advantage on blue die.
So what does it look like when you use the force to like confound them, Belsa? Like,
I think you see me in the crowd, but I'm like not quite in the crowd. I've kind of reached the crowd. Mm-hmm. And I can see Lana's head bopping through the crowd, and I just kind of like reach out and like tap into her hatred,
mm-hmm.
To mask her presence from the
cool.
People.
Cool. Yeah. And it's making like it's affecting them, so they're like looking around, frightened. Like they should be more disciplined, but something is like, you know, causing them to be afraid, and that's making miss important detail.
Like in order to do it, I have to kind of like stop moving. Mm-hmm. So like he ends up getting them further ahead of me until I'm kind of like not really going to be able to help
that
scenario.
Oh, that's really cool. Okay, cool. Yeah. So Lana, you'll, so they have some advantages that'll cause you to add some extra black dice, but you have one boost die from your Sith friend. Okay. You have, whatever your skill is, the difficulty is one red and one purple.
Okay.
They're in a crowd, and the two of them are like working together to hide her. So I'm going to give them, two more black dice for the pool.
Okay.
But they're dragging somebody who's like barely conscious, so add another boost die.
Okay. Can I use a dark side point or light side point?
Yeah, you can use a destiny point, sure.
Time. Okay. This is your time for revenge. This is all you. Take it. Use it.
How do I switch it over? I can't find it. Oh, there it is. There you go. And so is that just one upgrade?
Yeah, put an upgrade on your side and then make sure you click out of it.
I don't get, like, I know this is a dumb question maybe, but I don't get anything for, like, being a bounty hunter and this kind of being my job.
No, I mean, that's why you're trained in the skill. Okay.
And do you have any combat modifiers or anything that you put points into when we first started?
A lot of it's like tanky stuff because we didn't have a tank.
You get one blue dice from me. You have a pretty good shot at making this.
Okay. Yeah. Then I think I will roll. Which one do I roll again? Stealth.
Yeah, stealth. So this is you getting yourself into a position where you can leap from the shadows at them.
You got this. Believe in the dream.
Ooh, okay. So the opportunity to spring the trap, I think just never, it never comes up. There's always someone in their way. Like we see you moving towards them, and I think you bump into somebody right at the last second, or rather they bump into you because you're all grace like a fucking space panther. But somebody bumps into you and shouts angrily, like some Gamorrean like bumps into you and he's like, oh, hey, what are you doing? Yeah. And that, like his bellowing voice causes them to turn. And so you see these two guys, they're still dressed in the like ganger stuff, but they have like cloaks on. And they turn and look. And
take out my pistol and shoot him?
Yeah, and so this is the thing, you have a moment to act where you have a clear line of sight between you and them. And you have three advantage from your stealth. Even though you failed the stealth roll, you still have the advantage, so.
Okay. Yeah, I want to take out my pistol and shoot at her.
Yeah, so just shoot her between the two of them.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, sure. What is the roll?
I think you're within pistol range, so you can use your pistol, but it's going to be medium. So you're at two purple for difficulty. Okay. I'm going to use a destiny point.
And can I use my advantage to help boost my roll?
Yes. Yeah, you can.
How many would that be? Just one?
Yeah, I think that we talked about this in the last light side thing. There isn't anything that I could see that says you're limited in the number of boost dice you can add. Yeah. So I think you can add all three of them if you want to.
Okay. Well, I'm going to do that.
It'll probably mostly just generate you more advantage. So here's the thing. You've got your difficulty. It's two purple. There's one upgrade on the difficulty side
from you.
And then you're firing through a crowd. So throw another black die on there. Okay.
Pretty good
chance at it.
Maybe.
Yeah, there you go. Okay. So she's already pretty injured, so I'm gonna say that this like puts her over her threshold and knocks her out.
Okay.
So you just turn and fire a shot. She's like slips out of one of the guy's hands and like kind of like falls to the ground. The other guy drops down next to her and is like grabs her to see if she's like still alive. And the other guy is like pulling out a blaster pistol and firing back at you. And the crowd is starting to like spread out and panic a little bit.
And I'm going to take out my sword again and try to run at him again.
Right. Okay. So sure. Yeah. I mean, that's one way to deal with someone pulling a gun on you is charge them.
Yeah. Well, okay. He's a beast.
Yeah. I'll have him take a shot at you and then you can, you'll be within range.
Can I, comms this information as they start engaging each other back to Tharren?
Yeah. 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 Totally.
So I think after she blasts, the prisoner and she goes down, and the other guy pulls out his pistol, I kind of like lean back in an alley against the wall. And I just comms to Tharren and I say, Lana's engaging them in the plaza.
Do we hear commotion out? Like, how far away is this comparatively to where
we're? It's a few blocks away.
But would we hear like an uproar from a crowd? Like,
I think yeah. I mean, the middle city is like you're like kind of in a cave, right? So there's a lot of echo. And I think there's a distinct sound of blaster fire. You hear a couple of shots.
All right. So I imagine that if the crowd is parting, then there's going to be a clear path now. So Theron shouts to ZN and is like, he's like, ZN, save our team. And they sort of just like goes back to work inside the building.
Yeah, I just turned to the door, and then you see like a little, or actually no, I turn to the door, go into the ball, and then you see a little antenna come up, and it kind of just spins around because I'm doing a general purpose scan.
Okay.
Adam, to just like see if there's any other rebels or anything.
Mm-hmm.
Is that based off perception?
I think so. What page is it on?
It is on page 191.
Okay. And it's let's see here. Oh, I see. So it's a piece of like built-in gear.
Yeah. Does that even have a role?
No, I think, it gives you nearby life signs, heat signatures, sources of radiation, source and direction of various sounds. It's a useful piece of equipment up to 1.5 kilometers away. So yeah, they're definitely within range.
So you could just tap into my comms device.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So yeah, I just do that. And then I'll just try to, I don't say roll out, but I literally just like roll out of the bar as fast as possible.
You say roll out.
You have to say it. I roll out. Say it.
Roll out.
Yep.
And then I roll out
in the ball.
Yeah, and then I try to get there as fast as possible.
Okay, cool. So we'll do a quick like see if Lana gets shot before she falls on this dude. So I'll roll for the rebel trooper, and he'll get one shot at you as you rush him, and then you'll crash into him, be able to make your attack.
Come on, crappy rolls. Yes. No whammies. Big bucks.
All right, Lance Infantry, ranged heavy. He's got a range light. He's got one. So let's take. Ranged light, he's got one. And the difficulty is just one because you're at short range. Okay. So we see him like he pulls the pistol out and points it at you, but instead of firing right away, like he takes a deep breath and tries to focus, like waiting for you to get into short range, and then fires, hoping that he can put you down before you get to him.
Are short and engaged different?
No, engaged is like a form of short range.
So wouldn't that technically be like melee range then?
No. He's waiting. He's holding his action until you're close enough. Like he definitely gets. You're charging a guy with a gun. He definitely gets to shoot at you.
No. I agree.
So
it would be like based on like my defenses. But yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So he does hit you. But he's only got a blaster pistol. So he deals however much damage a blaster pistol does. You take 7 wounds minus your armor, or your soak rather.
So it'd be 2 wounds?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So he hits you, but your armor absorbs most of the shot. Maybe it like turns.
It grazes against the skin of my shoulder, and I just like keep going. I like flinch back a little bit, and then as I flinch back, I also raise my sword.
Nice. So. Use the momentum to like get the sword ready to go. And then you jump at him, and he like shouts in panic as you take a swing.
And two.
Yeah.
Purple, and then nothing else, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. Oh my gosh, serious.
All right, so you don't hit him. He like jumps back, and you swing at him and take a gouge out of the Duracrete at his feet. And people are starting to like create kind of like a barrier around you because there's like a fight happening.
Yeah.
The other rebel is pulling a pistol. And he's like pointing it and trying to like because you're all up in the business of his friend, and he's like trying to shoot you, but he's trying also not to shoot his friend.
So never mind. Okay. Yeah, that's fine.
All right. So what's the short, rather than saying your entire call sign, JP, what's the short version you want us to use for your character?
ZN is fine.
ZN? Okay. I will try to not be Canadian at you. Especially because...
Well, no. It's ZN versus Z.
I know, right? Like
that's why I want to do it, is because we got to set it right. It's actually Z. It's not Z.
All right. ZN. Let's see. So if you just at like a normal rolling pace with the crowd and everything in effect, it would take you, I'd say like three full rounds. But if you want to make a, I guess, athletics roll.
Yep.
You can just like barrel through the crowd, and every success you get will reduce that three by one.
Great. What?
So if you can get three successes, then you'll just be there now, basically just blast through the crowd.
But we need to know how many people he trampled in the process.
Yeah, we'll figure that out in a day.
Okay. So what am I rolling then? What?
Roll athletics against a difficulty of two.
Okay. So I just want to make sure I'm doing this right, because I haven't done this yet. Mm-hmm. I'm rolling athletics, but
yeah.
I also have physical training, which adds boost dice per rank of physical training to athletics and resilience checks, and that's rank two. So I'm adding two blue dice.
Two boost dice, yeah. You are very physical.
Okay, here's the roll. Also, you're muted, Sam. Character.
Beef tank.
Oh, I was just saying you're a fucking monster.
Here we go. Here's the roll. I'm excited because I have five brawn. And that, what? Why did that? Oh.
Oh,
no, I rolled the wrong thing. I rolled the wrong thing.
Yeah, you just rolled the pool. Those are all the modifiers.
There we go.
That's much better.
Oh, my God.
So not only does it take you zero rounds to get there, like you arrive now, you get five advantage that you can throw around as a result. So there's this crowd, right? And like the crowd is moving slowly because half of the people there are like, oh, God, a fight. I'm trying to get away. And the other half are, ooh, a fight, I want to go check it out. So there's all these people like pushing up against each other, and there's like a crowd. And in the middle of it, there's this melee going on. And then basically someone fires a cannonball into the crowd. are you just barreling through people and like throwing them aside?
I think Elsa's like just ends her comm device call. And she's in an alley next to the fight. And she just starts seeing people fucking fly into the air.
Yeah, I think
a huge metal ball just rolls straight past her with like this Empire signal, and she just goes, oh, thank God. Like, like relaxes.
Yeah, I think if people want to see what it looks like, here, I can show you. Or wait, I don't know why it opened in Photoshop, but we actually had it drawn by the same person that did all the other stuff. So
oh, shit.
We could show it off real quick. It looks like this. She did a good job.
Nice.
So that's like kind of what you see in ball form is the sphere with the gear on it, and then you can see the actual droid there. We might change the hands a little bit, but yeah. Anyways, that's what you see. I don't come out of the ball form when I roll in. I just kind of like if I roll over people, I roll over people. I don't care about the how many people die or how many people don't die, because I'm not worried about that. I'm just trying to get into the fight.
I love how because the Imperial symbol and the Rebel symbol are like they're symbols of a piece of media that we absorb. We don't like shy away the idea of them being spray painted on everything. Like this would be the equivalent of taking a Sherman tank and spray painting it red, white, and blue with a giant star on the front.
Yeah.
So that's good. Damn right.
So yeah, you like roll through the crowd. People are like running out of the all these meat bags are scattering. And the guy that's trying to take a shot at Lana stops and turns and looks at it. And he's like, is that a destroyer? And the other one's like dodging you, trying not to get stabbed. I think you can...
do we need to roll some initiative?
You can act. Let's just go ahead and because these guys, I don't think, are going to they're gonna last very long. Lana, do you want to try and take another swing at one of them?
Yeah, I'm gonna take another swing.
Okay, cool. Yeah, they're suitably distracted by the rolling up of ZN.
Do I get advantage at all from either my last roll or his?
Yeah, ZN, what do you want to do with all that advantage? You can.
I'll give whatever it is that'll help out Lana. I give okay. One or two to her.
Like we could say it's the distraction of him rolling in. Gives me advantage.
Definitely. Oh, that's 100% what's happening. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the guy like looks over at the droid. Take a couple of boost dice.
And then two purple and then roll.
Yeah. And then two purple.
Okay. Well, let's see how this goes. Yay.
There you go. So much advantage. All right. So what's your brawn?
My brawn is 3.
3. Okay. So you do 5, 6 damage.
Here's 2, vicious 1.
Okay. Yeah. He's not wearing any armor.
Oh, okay.
And he's got, oh yeah, no, he's out. You get rid of him. Yeah.
Okay, the one that was like saying no, I get rid of him.
Yeah. Well, the guy that you charged at first, you like jump back trying to like, oh shit, there's someone with a sword in my face.
Yeah.
If you, you got enough to trigger, crits because your critical is 2, right? So the damage isn't what gets him, but you kill him.
Okay.
He turns to look at this droid and then you stab him. And we see the droid and the other rebel, and the rebel's just like firing his pistol at this droid. So I'm gonna take a shot at you, ZN, and then you can tell me what you do in response.
Great. I'm gonna use the remaining 3 advantage to gain +1 range defense until the end of the next turn.
Perfect. Yeah. Maybe he's hitting someone who's still stuck to you. So he's at short range. That's your character sheet. He's at short range and you have a defense. And then your armor gives you an additional one, right? You have like a built-in 1 defense?
Yes, I have 1 defense, yes.
Perfect.
To range and melee.
All right. Well, if I want any chance of being able to hit, I'm going to have to spend a destiny point. So I will do that. Buy myself an upgrade. And let's take the shot. Range late. Nope. Armor too good. So yeah, he's panicking and he's just firing at you. And we're seeing the blaster bolts just deflect off of your perfect mirrored sphere chassis. What do you do?
I mean, I think you just see like one arm go in and then the other arm turns into the vibro sword. I would be really slow. I don't know. You tell me, but I just kind of start walking towards him, like with the loudest fucking crunches on the ground. Cause I'm a 6-foot
gigantic droid. I think they're actually fairly fast. They're at least like human speed.
Okay. Then it's much like, it's much like the XCOM, 2 and XCOM 1. What are the multi-leg spider looking guys, whatever those are called in that game. Mm-hmm. It's like that type of walk, just like hastily walking up there. And then you just see the axe like come down.
Nice. All right. Cool. Yeah. Go ahead and make an attack.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a scuttle. Exactly. So it's, difficulty is 2 purple.
Okay. And this would be a melee attack, correct?
Yeah, you should be able to just use the button on the axe.
Okay. Here's the roll.
Okay.
Oh God.
Oh, he dead.
And it has Sunder and Vicious 3.
Yes. So it deals 8 damage plus the 3 that you got on the dice, so 11 damage. It inflicts a crit, which you don't need. And then also, yeah, pierces, reduces armor. Sunder is like you use it to break gear that people are using, right?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
And then vicious means that the crit would be 30 points more than it was. So yeah, so you just come scuttling over and then the axe comes down and the guy just down to the ground.
Yeah, out. So even without like, there's no feeling in it, whatever, the second that happens, you just see a little antenna come up and I just scan the area again afterwards to make sure there's stuff
I don't
there.
Even like watch as this happens. I just go and check and see if the prisoner's still alive.
Yeah, she is. She's like kind of like sitting up, holding her like chest where you shot her.
Then I sheath my sword and then pick her up and throw her over my shoulder. Start walking back towards where I last saw Belsa or felt. I don't know. Did I feel Belsa whenever she was helping at all?
No. Belsa. Well, Belsa's the only one.
Then I turn around and walk back to where I came from.
Oh, yeah, Adam. I'll use that 2 advantage to actually perform the immediate free maneuver of scanning.
Sure.
So that makes sense, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. Why don't you make a perception check?
All right, here's where the first time the character does not wow people.
Difficulty difficulty 3. There's a lot of signals in the area.
Okay. Here's the roll.
yeah. So No, you can't. Like I said, if you're trying to pick up the difference between like random people and potential rogue, like you're scanning for weapons in the crowd, right? And so there's lots of people that are armed, but you can't tell one from another.
Okay. So yeah. that like happens, I scan, and then like over the loudspeaker, I'll just say like,
"No enemies detected. Returning to Theron."
And then I just turn into the robot and just roll back to Theron.
And I try to like scuttle behind him as like fast as possible with this woman, because he's obviously making a path.
Isn't that cute, Theron? You have your own giant, horribly violent, axe-wielding BB-8 droid.
According to the wiki, it says I can move 70... You're not going to allow this. It says I can move 75 kilometers per hour in the ball mode. That's much faster than running.
It's, you can, yeah, it's in open terrain. Like, if it were, like, traveling from one place to another, yeah, you totally can. Like, if you were like, I need to get from, like, this place to another fast, yeah, that's top travel speed. Over land, not okay. Like in an enclosed space. It's not worried about that.
Gotcha. So yeah, I
mean, you made it there in three, less than three turns.
Yeah,
you're part true. Droid, you're part droid, part vehicle. It's cool.
That's true. So yeah, Jesse, you just once again you hear the fucking rumbling from afar.
The rumbling.
And I just like pop into the middle of the floor and go into the droid form, and then my head just turns to you, and I don't even say anything. I'm just like sitting there in the room.
A few minutes later.
yeah so you're all gonna head back to the
we're gonna head bar. Back to the thing, the bar. Yeah,
okay, all right. Yeah, so in the bar, Theron, what have you been doing? Like what's happening when everybody gets back?
Just gathering what guys are still alive, trying to figure out which of my men are still alive and able to fight.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, you're doing okay. Like the arrival of your new droid definitely turned the tide for you. You kept all your main guys and managed to just lose some of the like lower level guys. They've just culled the bottom tier of the organization.
Great. That's fine by me. Yeah. So I wait till everyone gets back and then go over to Lana and sort of look at her prisoner and then look back at her and like, "You didn't kill her?"
I just like,
"Does like, someone need killing?"
I throw her down on like the nearest table. It probably has like blood on it and whatnot. And I'm like, "Sir, I returned her. Is she of no use to us now?"
Theron just like has the biggest smile on his face. He's like, "I've trained you so well and I have a droid." And he like does like just like a happy dance over to one of his men and sort of like pats him on the back. He's like, "It is a great day." And like
you see her face, just like she's totally like stone face except for like an eyebrow arches, like she's just watching.
Yeah So you're all like there and you're all excited, and I think that you hear a voice, and the music takes like a sudden turn to like a kind of like, there's like some quiet like violins, a little bit of like sad music that comes up, and we hear someone. It's Mr. Pooch. He's like, "Sir," and you look over, and he looks at you, and he's just like, he's pale, and he looks like, you know, he's like, it's Cheezle, sir. And the camera pans over to what looks like a wet rug, but then we realize is actually is Cheezle, and he's like, he's lying on his back, he's like holding his stomach, and he's got like blood on his face, and he looks up at you, and he's like like coughs dramatically.
Theron pushes guys out of the way and like runs over to him and kneels beside him, and he's like, "Cheezle. Jeez, it'll be okay." And he's like trying to put his like guts back in him.
Yeah, he like reaches up, and he just like gestures like for you to come closer.
And Theron like gets down beside him and so like holds him tight.
Yeah, so you like lean in, and he's like, "Ay, ay, 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 ay," and then like goes limp in your arms. And Mr. Pooch behind, he like takes his helmet off and just like holds it in front of his chest and like shakes his head.
Theron, like, it's almost Terminator music-esque. It's like, da-da-da-da-da. He, like, slowly rises up, and you can see his shoulders come up. And he has, like, the blood all over his hands, and he just wipes it on his
Perfect.
And he's like, no one else dies. And, like, he's full, like, he's like, oh, yeah. Oh, it's
so
on
mad.
Now we're gonna, now it's on to find green skin. Like, this
oh,
is
fuck.
He's covered in his friend's blood.
Oh, man.
Da, 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 da.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Amazing. Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Should we grab a break there?
Yeah, I totally lost track of time because we were having so much fun.
I know, me too.
We're like 20 minutes over break time. So, shit. Jesus Christ. All right, yeah, we'll take this quick break. We'll be right back with more Bounce Power. Still about 2 hours left to go, so we'll see you guys right after this. See you then.